Hey guys, welcome to Honey Badger Art Stream. This is something that we wanted to do for a while, so I saw an opportunity and figured we'd go ahead and do it. I know it's very spontaneous, but if you are listening, thanks for joining us. If you're here live, if you're listening later, then thanks for listening and watching the video and stuff. So I'm here with. How do you pronounce it? Is it Kukuruyo? Kukuruyo?
Just say Cuckoo.
Cuckoo? Okay. So I'm here with Cuckoo. He does the art for the shows just like I do. Normally he does the Thursday show, but you guys may know him better as the guy who does the Gamergate Life comic strips. He's been doing them. You've been doing them since the Gamergate thing started, right?
Yeah, more or less.
Yeah, so he all those short, like really funny Gamergate strips with Vivian and Lillian, and they're always topical and stuff with things that are going on. He's the guy who makes those comics, and he also does the he has his own web comic. I'll put links to his stuff below. So, and we're just drawing. Figured I'm going to be drawing online anyway, so. Ku, what are you working on right now? I'm going to share your screen.
A page for one of my comics, the Monster Girls webcomic.
Yes. And you're from Spain, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, guys, he has a bit of a thick accent. He's been on our show once before, too, actually. But, bear with him. I think his English is good. I think your English is good for, do you learn it in school over there?
No. Or
no? Then how did you learn English?
Video games.
Really?
Yeah.
That's interesting. It's very good. I watch tons of anime and I still don't know that much Japanese, so it's pretty awesome. But we're just he's working on his comic page. While I do have my own commissions and stuff that I have to do, I figured for this I would leave it up to you guys. So if you guys have any ideas or things that you'd like to see drawn in the chat, I'm watching the chat. I'll periodically look at it to see what suggestions you might have. In the meantime, I'm going to draw my own thing. So
now is when someone asks for a Star Wars spoiler in the chat.
Yeah, somebody, I was just going to say, I was going to draw a Star Wars spoiler. So I did watch it. Did you see it yet?
No, but I have already seen like 3 spoilers.
Oh, really? Well, I'm sure that whatever you might see isn't, it may not feel as new as you would think. That's about the extent of what I would say. So, do you have any interest in seeing the Star Wars movie?
Not really. I will probably download it.
You will probably what?
Download the movie.
Download it. Yeah, I can see that. I saw it last night, and that's why I wasn't on the Honey Badger show, because I went to go see Star Wars. But I did, I don't know, I did write a thing up instead, so I did my homework. I did extra credit so I wouldn't have to be on the show so I can go see the movie. But so it was all right.
I will probably try to write something for the Honey Badgers when the elections here end.
When the what happens?
The elections.
Oh, okay.
It's this Sunday, so because I don't know if there is one political party, extreme left,
is full
of feminists and social justice warriors, and they can win the elections.
Oh, scary!
So we can become Sweden.
Yay! Everybody's becoming Sweden. Yeah, that's terrifying. Let's see if anybody has any comments here. Please, no spoilers. Yeah, no, Clark, I'm not actually going to spoil it. That would be mean. That would be something that only a Sith would deal a spoiler in January. So I don't see why how that would be a problem.
There is a movie that I think you should make a podcast or something.
Okay.
I don't remember the name right now. Maybe you have seen it. It's a movie. It's a black guy arrives. I don't know who is the word in English. He left his house and go to another house to live. Who is the word?
Moved?
Yeah. He moved to another town. And because he's black, when people sees him with, you know, televisions and stuff, they call the police.
Oh, okay.
And it happens that in the house there is a white thief.
A white thief? Oh, okay, yeah. Okay.
So the police arrives, and he kidnaps the black guy, and the police surrounds the place thinking it is the black guy, the one who has kidnapped the white guy.
Oh.
And it's an interesting movie. I think the black guy is Samuel L. Jackson. The interesting thing is that it shows both racism and social justice, because the black guy is totally obsessed with, he thinks everyone and everything is racist. And there is a point that a dog barks at him and he says, "That's because I'm black."
Really?
And the white guy, he has a lot of arguments with him about that. Like, you're upset. Not everyone is racist. It's an interesting movie with that theme. And I don't remember the name of the movie. It's an old movie.
I think I know what that movie is, but I bet the chat can tell, because I think you're right. I think it is a Samuel L. Jackson.
Yeah,
it's a Samuel L. Jackson movie. Let's see. Yeah, it's police are called. White Man Brings Trouble. It's a black exploitation movie. No. Were you about to spoil the movie? Is it still? Somebody said that the stream was. It stopped. But it looks like it's going again. Has the stream? Is the stream looks good, guys? It looks like it's good. So. I won't sweat it. But I think maybe is it a Time to Kill? That sounds like, I think Sandra Bullock is in it too, but I could be wrong. For a while, Samuel Jackson was in every movie, so it was very difficult to know if he was in, you know, which movie he might have been in.
The joke with the dog probably is easy to find.
That's probably right. They'll probably tell us in a second. So we're only going to be able to do this stream for like an hour, because there's a Rant Zerker afterwards, guys, that are listening. And that'll be Karen and Allison are going to be taking the reins. And apparently on YouTube, I don't think that two streams on the same channel can be going at the same time. So we're just going to go for as long as we can. We'll see what happens. So, that's a little too exaggerated. I'm getting a little bit of lag from my pen. It's kind of annoying. So, I'm using, for those of you guys who might be wondering, I'm using an Intuos 4 Pro to do the drawing. So I'm looking at a tablet, or I'm drawing on a tablet, and I'm trying to get it as close as I can So I'm looking at, it's a little bit awkward, but that's just the nature of the beast. Ku, you're using a Cintiq, is that right? Yep. Or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so he gets to draw right on the freaking screen. So I want to make sure, because it looks like it's only sharing my thing, and I don't want to do that. So let me put yours on so people can see what you're doing. Oh, maybe it's because I just talk more than you. That is that a boob at the top? It looks like a boob.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a boob.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, it's a boob.
It has a lot of boobies.
That's yeah. Almost as many as Dead or Alive Extreme 3. Almost.
That's maybe because I am misogynist, obviously.
Obviously, yes, obviously. Let's see. I'm actually using, I think we're both using the same program. We're both using Manga Studio. Mm-hmm. I have Manga Studio 5. Is that the same one that you have?
Yeah, I have the X version.
Yeah, EX, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the one I'm using too. So I am running into some strange issues. I think it's probably the driver or something. I don't know. Try not to think about it too much.
It's not a guy. It's this woman. The chat.
What?
There's someone in the chat saying if he can be the guy here, but it's a woman.
Oh. So, I think that in general, when it comes to the process, most people, they generally work the same. My art instructor used to say, when you're drawing, always go from the general to the specific, which means, you know, you draw like the basic shapes and what it's going to fill before you, start adding like all kinds of detail, because it's very easy to want to draw details, but you have to resist it.
They are asking for a Spanish streaming.
Spanish streaming?
Yeah.
Well, if you want to say some things in Spanish, go ahead. I won't know what you're saying, but.
Sí, puedo decir cosas en español.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't no hablo español very well.
I think most of the lines that I hear in the United States when they try to speak Spanish, they are all wrong.
What you mean, like when people are what do you mean, like the accent is wrong, or the words are wrong?
The construction of the phrase is
usually wrong. Oh yeah, yeah, I'm sure.
But it's funny anyways. We usually don't correct people when someone comes to Spain and talks like that. We don't correct them because it's funnier. In fact, right. Never trust what a Spaniard tells you. He probably gonna lie about what you are saying.
Right. Yes, Sleepy Doodle, I do commissions. I would like this to be my job, much in the same way that it is a job for Ku. And I'd like to be able to quit my job, because I have to go to my job in a little while, and I hate my job. So I'd like to quit it. So yes, I take commissions. If you want, you could email me at bmartinez37@hotmail.com or follow me on Twitter and send me a message through there. If there's something that you want.
What is a Redbubble page?
Redbubble?
Yeah.
It's kind of a ripoff, but okay. So you in Redbubble, you can take your art and a piece that you've made, and you can essentially sell it to be printed on things like mugs and iPhone cases and t-shirts. And so it lets you sell your work. The only thing is that Redbubble makes most of the profit. So if you make an art piece and you put it on an iPhone case for sale, Redbubble will actually print it on the iPhone case and ship it to the people who want to buy it. But you will maybe get 50 cents for every iPhone case they sell. So your artwork is helping them sell iPhone cases. And you're getting some money, but it's not a lot. That's the only thing.
I have a spreadsheet page.
I'm sorry?
Spreadsheet is 40 shirts.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know.
And they pick, they take the base spends, I think it's $9, and you decide what, how many much of that you want to do.
Oh, no, I don't have, yeah, they're asking me if I don't have one. I don't have a Redbubble page because I don't, it's a ripoff. But, I think that, you know, before you start selling t-shirts and things like that, for, let's say for you, Yuku, you have a comic, your Monster Girls comic, right? Mm-hmm. And I have my comic. And, but you can't really start selling t-shirts and, you know, merchandise for your comic until it's popular enough that people will spend the money on it. Oh, so yeah, it's.
I mean, you can, if in this page, you don't pay for the shirts. You just add the design, and if someone mm-hmm. wants the shirt, the website takes care of everything.
Yes, the only downside is that you don't get a lot of profit. You get very little money.
You get what you decide. They have a base price, and you add what you want.
Oh, really? It's pretty cool. Okay. So I'm still doodling. Well, maybe I'll, that's not a bad idea. I actually have some things that I made that are, I was making fun of the band comic artwork, you know, like the Batgirl,
with the Joker.
Yes, yes. Man, how do I? Well, whatever. I made one of that. I made one of the Spider Woman. Actually, did that for the. I also used it for the nerd revolt. There's a picture of Vivian and a honey badger, and they're playing video games on the floor, and Vivian is in the Spider-Woman pose. Hmm. And rotating. And I did one with where I took the Batgirl, the new Batgirl that feminists and social justice warriors like so much. And I made her, I made a different character that's more curvy and sexy. And I had her in a bathroom taking a selfie with a lot of really angry feminists, specific ones too. Lori Penny, Anita, Lacey Green, and Big Red. And I had some fun with that, and I thought I'd like to put those on shirts at some point, maybe. That could be fun.
Yeah, I think that more and more people is going to want to have a t-shirt against feminims.
That what?
That people is probably going to want t-shirts and things like that to make people know they are against feminism.
Yes. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Something that would...
Like the feminist t-shirts are everywhere.
Let's see what the chat's saying now. Every time I hear coup, I think of Antonio Banderas. Well, yeah.
Antonio.
Let's see. You have to say, let's play. Let's see. Awesome. Oh, it's Sleepy Doodle. Awesome, because your style is very well developed. It looks like American comic books, similar to a few artists I know. Contact me at goldenkeygirl@mail.com. Well, Sleepy Doodle, tweet at me at Zanamaru, and you should be able to reach me that way. Let's see. Playing Torchlight. Oh, they're just chit-chatting. I've seen some of your work, and I want it on my wall. Okay. Well, thank you, Lightning Rambles. I think that, yeah, posters, I think I could do. I'm still developing. I think we always feel like we could be better.
Posters sell very well, or at least I sell very well posters.
Do you? Oh, yeah. Because you go to cons and stuff, right? Hmm. Is that what you sell the most when you,
Yeah, it's like, last month, there was a big convention and I won about $800.
Whoa. Wait, you made $800?
Yeah.
That's good. How much did the table cost, though? Because those always cost money, right?
It's an expensive event, so it was about $200.
Okay. Do you think that you made back what it was worth? Sometimes, yeah. You know, when you think about, okay, yeah, because the posters cost money, but you make enough copies and it doesn't really matter.
Yeah. It's worth it. It depends I don't know how much cost to make a poster there, but I have mine cost about 50 cents each poster.
Mm-hmm.
So I can sell them for euro. That's, I don't know, like $6 or something like that.
Yeah.
But you have to make things that you don't like.
You mean like... stuff that has a fan following?
Yeah. Like the posters that I like the most are things like animes that I watch, but people don't watch them. So you have to make Naruto and things like that.
I understand what you mean completely. As a JoJo fan, I know that if I made a bunch of JoJo stuff, which I have, no one would buy it because it's not as popular. And everyone would instead want me to do Monster Musume or... something like that. And it's not that I've never watched it, but I would be out of my element. Or last time I went to a con, which wasn't that long ago, everyone was I was getting requests for Rurouni Kenshin. And I was like, wow, that's old. Mm-hmm. But I looked it up online and I gave her the art and she was very happy.
What most people ask, at least in Spain, it's Yaoi.
Oh, see, Yaoi, I have no experience with.
That myth that the males are the pervy ones. No, no, women, women.
Oh, I know. Oh, yeah, I know. Especially because a very sexually perverse woman is actually liberated. And so it's not actually a bad thing. It is for men, though. So, of course, you're going to have yaoi. I don't get it. But, you know, to each his own. I don't get it. But
they like it. They pay.
Yeah, they pay. Right, exactly. So, you know, I'm already over it.
Most people don't want to do it. Like, I'm one of the few artists in the conventions that do that.
The yaoi?
Yeah.
How do you do it? How do you, it's just, you just think about the money and you just keep going?
Is it pushing through? I mean, it's just a nude body. That's it.
Yeah. Do you go fully nude, or do they want it more like, you know, soft core? Yeah. But I mean, like, what do you normally ask? What requests do you normally get? Do you get like requests for soft core, like Skinemax nude, or like full on, like, you know,
the most I get requested is
power top,
like soft yaoi of Eren Yeager and Levi from Shingeki no Kyojin.
So a lot of, it's more like romance?
Yeah.
Okay.
But there's some women also that ask for hard porn.
Yeah. Wow. That's interesting. Like, seriously, but let me see what the chat's saying while I'm drawing this. What fresh hell is this? Brian, have you seen One Punch Man? Yes, I have. Yeah. put your Twitter handle in the chat. Sleepy Doodle, it's in there. Thank you. Thank you, Lightning Rambles. Because I was busy drawing an eyeball. Yaoi requests. I can do, I think everybody was asking for Max Dara to be shipped with mundane Matt, but I need something to work from. And I'll do it for an undisclosed amount of money, because
I got a request to do Sargon in yaoi.
Sargon in yaoi with, like, yeah. Big eyes. That's pretty funny. I think actually I don't know if I want to see the yaoi, but I would be curious to see how that would look.
And I think the other one was, I mean, it was Sargon with Milo, I think.
Of course.
Everybody wants to. I don't think Milo would be opposed to it.
No, I don't think Milo would be opposed to it. Although he might let you know that your waifu was shit. I think that would be the thing that you're going to get from him. Because he did a thing. What was it that he talked about? He made an article to be edgy, specifically.
The Digimon one?
Which one?
The Digimon is much better than Pokemon.
Did he say that?
Yeah, he made an article about that.
That's funny. It wasn't the Digimon one, but I think a lot of people are saying that. That's just... I don't follow Digimon or Pokemon, so to me it's the same crap. I'm more what's the one that had one of the creatures was like a giant eyeball? It wasn't Digimon or Pokemon. Monster something. Monster Trainer, Monster Rancher.
Oh. We have in Spain, there is a tradition in one of the conventions.
Yeah,
it's a battle between Digimon fans and Pokemon fans.
Really?
And they made it very realistic to the point that there was a television program from England that thought it was serious. And you can find in the internet they made a documentary about that, and you can see the people in both sides fighting like. If they were truly fighting in fist fights, but it's on the stage.
Yeah. When they catch those on a phone, or like, you know, like somebody records it on their phone at World Star Hip Hop. something like that.
Like if they were really fighting and someone has
recorded it. Yeah.
But it's all false.
Yeah, I've seen those. Those are pretty funny. I'm gonna make this thinner because lips are too ladylike. Lady lips.
Draw jury of Lauren Southern, Karen, or Allison.
Yuri of Lauren Southern, Karen, and Allison. That'd be funny. Pretty good. Actually, I wanted to do something with Lauren Southern. I can't remember, like, art with her. Oh, because I had done, when I was at Victoria, I got to meet Lauren Southern, and it was like a meetup, and it was very crazy, and normally when things are a little too energetic for me, I'll go in the back and draw it's like meditative. And I drew a picture of everyone I was there with. So I had Mike, Rachel, Hannah, Lauren, Southern, Karen, Anna Cherry. We were all there. And I wanted to redraw it much better because it was just a doodle.
I think the first drawing I did for the show was with Karen and Allison in sexy superhero outfits.
Yep, it was the superhero one. I remember that. And Mike was like Wolverine or something. Yeah, I'm definitely experiencing some issues with my mouse. But that's okay. Making the most of it. That's what you got to do. Let me see what the chat is saying now. Do Marilyn Monroe pic of her. Of Lauren Southern? No. I have an idea. At some point in the future, I'm going to bring Margaret McLennan on as on a Nerd Revolt show or on a fireside chat. But if she's going to be on a Nerd Revolt, something that I make art for, I'm going to draw Margaret as Marilyn Monroe. Because if you don't know Margaret McLennan, she's the belly dancer girl that has a... She has like she's missing her. She has no intestines or large intestine. She's basically the Marilyn Monroe of anti-feminism. So I will probably do that for her. I'm going to let me save this for right now, and I'm going to close and reopen and see if it fixes my go to desktop. I'm going to close and reopen this program. So for now, I'm not going to present and see if it fixes the lag on my thing.
I usually forgot to save my page.
Yeah, save right now. I was doing something yesterday and I didn't save. And
it's my fault of the site. I bought it's kind of a battery. It's called a site. And if the electricity goes down, the PC still works. So I always forget to save because of that.
Let me see if this works better. Please work, please work, please work. Oh. Oh yeah, there we go. Okay, so I'm gonna share again. I'm gonna very briefly go get a third cup of coffee because I need it. So I'll be right back. Now I'm in Paint Tool Sai, but so I think that my manga studio, because I haven't had this plugged in for a while in the in this computer, my manga studio is not liking the pen right now, so I'm just going to work inside for the rest of the show. But I'll be right back. I'm going to go get another cup of coffee.
No, manga studio doesn't have an autosave, and it should have an autosave, but they don't do it. Must be one of the few things that Manga Studio doesn't have. This is well, it's called either Manga Studio or Clip Studio Paint. The interface is very similar to Photoshop, but it has a lot more options for drawing. Photoshop is very limited. In fact, it's not a program to draw. It's for photography.
All right, I'm back. Oh, crap. I almost spilled my coffee. That would have been awful. So, Ku, are you still there?
Yeah.
Of course you are. I was just so in the chat, Lightning Rambles says that there's an autosave program called Broken Pens Autosave. So I guess it automatically saves for you. So you might want to look into that. If you have a, you know, I do the same thing where I forget to save, and then sometimes it I'll lose work that I've been doing for a while, and it can be really frustrating. So, all right, that's too thick.
Yeah, it has never happened to me since I have the batteries, but I sometimes spend the whole day doing a drawing and I forget to save in the whole day. So,
yeah.
Someday it's going to happen something bad.
Oh, no, that happened to me yesterday. I was doing something at work, and it was coming along really good. I was very happy with it. And then suddenly my computer crashed, and I had not saved for a long time because I was on a roll, and I was just going, going, going. I was very happy with what I was making. So sometimes you're drawing and you like, you know, really love what you're doing. And then you forget that you haven't saved in a while. So, oh my God.
Saving is for pushies.
Yeah, that's right. Now I'm experiencing lag in here. What the hell? Could it be because I'm trying to do this at the same time?
Never. They say in the chat they go to, or they want to go to art university. Never go to art university.
Yeah, don't do it. I did it. You don't need it. Just there's plenty of YouTube tutorials online. You literally don't need it.
I think that the universities for art nowadays are like, I don't know, a nest of social justice warriors.
Oh, absolutely. My school is like notoriously social justice warrior-ish. It's just.
I think that's the like. The main reason when I'm against that kind of people is because I have gone to art school, so I know how a world of social justice warriors is.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Open recent.
I have a Picarto. It's the same name, Gurullo, but I have only used it once, and I didn't know that you have to click to record the stream, so I lost the stream.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you have to click to open the stream and stream, and click in another button to save the stream.
Oh, well, this one should automatically upload once it's done. Well, actually, maybe not, because Google's been weird lately. So that also may be a problem. What's going on?
They say university teach you how to use the internet.
Yeah, it's true. There's a lot of,
I think it teach you, art teach me how to, I don't know who's the word in English, like to lie to seem like you are better.
Oh yeah, no, teach you how to bullshit. Absolutely. Well, that's the funny thing is, you know, I went to art school because I wanted to get better and be a stronger artist. I had gone to art school in the 90s, and then I didn't when I got out, because I had learned everything in traditional medium, and right around that time the digital thing was taking, it was just a gigantic trend in comics and in illustration. Everybody had to know Photoshop, everyone had to know you know, Illustrator, everyone had to know Quark and Shockwave and Flash and stuff like that. And I didn't know any of those things because it was optional. If you were, you know, if you were at the time that I was going to school.
And you probably, I knew more. I went to a few of those classes and I knew more than the teachers.
Yeah, right. It's, you know, those who can't do teach. So I was, oh man, this thing is really laggy. But when I, so I couldn't use the skills I had because it was just like painting and drawing and stuff. So then I worked regular jobs for a long time, and then I went back to I went back to school many years later. And one thing I wanted to do was learn all of the you know, digital stuff. And I tried teaching myself and things, you know, before I went to school. Then when I went back to school, they didn't actually teach me anything. They just,
Yeah, they have these theories. The thing you were talking about, the surrealism.
Yeah,
they just come from the base that everything is art, so you don't have to know to draw or to make sculptures. You just do whatever shit and you just made up something.
Exactly. You just you don't have to. You can just, you know, find a way to explain what you're doing, and then it justifies, you know, your shitty art. And
every people I know that went to art school just throw up at that. In the second year, you just stop trying to do things right.
Yeah.
Like, you stop trying to draw good or make good art. You just go with the flow.
Yeah, and yes, absolutely. And you don't have to, you don't have to be the best. You just have to, like, make an excuse. That was very common. There was also, nobody ever failed, no matter how bad they were. I mean, there were some people that were so bad. And I was like, why are you here? You suck. You know, it's just the worst. Like, they have no idea about anatomy. They, you know, they were always late with their work. It looked like garbage. And they would still pass the class because they had to, I guess. And those are the people that will have degrees and they won't be able to use it for anything. I think that's what that is. There are people who get these degrees and they don't ever use it for anything. And I think that if you want to do something with your skill, you have to be an entrepreneur. You have to make it, you know, happen. You have to sell yourself. And with the internet, we actually have the ability to do that pretty easily today, right? Otherwise, we'd have to rely on somebody hiring us. And, you know, I think that when people say, oh, you know, I can't find any work, I'm an artist, I can't find any work. I don't think you can really find work. You have to make work. You have to, like, you know, get good scrub and just sell yourself. And maybe after a while, you'll build your own brand, which is fine because a lot of people have done it, or you know, maybe you will get into something else. You might not even end up using your, that skill that you spent $80,000 getting because it's expensive. Art school is really expensive.
I didn't learn anything really art related in art.
What?
I didn't learn to draw or anything like that in art in school, in university.
Yeah.
Like, I learned things from history of art because that is something that you have to study.
Yeah. And actually there's stuff there that's useful. I actually really liked art history. I thought it was very informative. Especially because you can see where art changed from when it was something that, you know, people had to work hard at doing to something that, at least in the art world, all you had to do was, you know, have a good reason why you're justifying something. And then, you know, that would be like a way to explain that your art is good. Like, that was when they started making excuses, basically.
I tried to, in one of the classes I had, I and a friend, like, you have to, I think it was that you have to convince people why some kind of art you like is good. Mm-hmm. And we did it about video games. We basically tried to convince people that video games were art. And I don't know. It was almost everything in the room. I think that only the teacher agreed. All the people in the room were totally against the idea that a video game could be art.
Mm-hmm.
And the same people, they were totally in favor of things like performance and shit like that. Like,
oh,
there's a guy that did, and this literally, he picked a bed, not the entire bed, where you sleep in the bed.
Yeah, the mattress.
Yeah, the mattress, and he put it in the hall, in the main hall, and he take a nap, and that was his work of art.
Oh my god.
And that's better than video games, of course.
Of course. I but you know what though? I don't think that just because you call something art makes it good. I think that's just kind of a cop out, personally. I think you can call something art, but that doesn't make it a good thing just by that description. I just think that you're just you're trying to make it more valid by saying it's art, but I don't think it really is. I think it's just as just a way that it's being enjoyed.
The easiest way to define art today, I mean, art cannot be, it's very difficult to define. I don't think no one has a real explanation that convinces everyone about what is art, but the easiest way is art is what the status quo says is art.
Mm-hmm.
Like if the museum say that something is art, it's art, and that's it.
Oh, okay, so you default to the authority of the... of the art community, like
most of the famous artists, they do nothing. They do like they pick a bathroom and that's art. And it's just because the museum does an exposition with their work.
Yeah, well, that's the interesting thing about that in art history is that a lot of guys that we consider some of the greatest artists today, when they were alive, no one thought that they were any good. So it's almost like if you want to see what's art right now, you have to wait until everyone is dead and then see what people are calling art later. And then you'll know who like, you know, it could be, you know, manga could become art. Who knows? It could be in museums. Actually, in some places it is. But, you know, right now, nobody would ever say that. Like if you said, oh, you know.
Well, comic is an art. It has a number in the arts. I don't know if it was the 13 art, maybe.
It was a what?
It's officially an art. It has a number.
A number?
Yeah.
What does the
arts have number? You know the ninth art, cinema, etc. You know.
Yeah.
And it's officially the art community museums. I don't know who did it, but when I went to university, it was officially an art, and it has, I don't know if it was the 13 or 14 number of arts.
Hmm.
And video games too, but video games was very, very low, like the 20 or something like that.
Right. Yeah, no, some comic artists, here we have a modern museum called the MCA. It's called the MCA. And normally it's a contemporary or the contemporary art museum. So it may not be called the MCA. I can't remember. I hate that place because it's all of the really, you know, modern art that's just like, here's a sculpture of a woman peeing, you know. And here's like, you know, some chairs, I glued them together. I've seen that in there, you know, and some of it might be like a good amount of work, but I don't really see any like skill and I don't see anything aesthetic. But what I often see, and this is, I think, where it comes down to art for a lot of people today, it has to serve a purpose that is political. It has to say something and it has to say something specific. So this is why the art world is rife with social justice warriors and activists, because they think that by doing a spoken word poem, they're going to change the world. And the main reason why is because they don't have any, useful skills than doing anything else. So they make, you know, they make videos criticizing capitalism for their situation, even though the problem is, and I'm saying this as an artist myself, that they didn't, you know, they didn't have anything to contribute. So, and it makes them bitter, and they blame the system because they don't know how to take personal responsibility.
There was a meme a few days ago. It went viral in Spain. The Batman meme, the, you know, the one when he slaps Robin.
Oh yeah.
And the text was, I'm going to try to translate. Robin was saying, I do contemporary art because I like the deconstruction, and then Batman say, no, it's because you don't know how to draw. and I think everyone in Spain agrees with that, because we have one of the, I think it's one of the most important contemporary art museums in, it's in Spain, and every year when they do their annual exposition is stupid, the things that told them. Mm-hmm. Like this year, I think it was this year or last year, they had just a glass of water half full or empty, and I don't know. And that's it. And the art was that you have to say if it's half empty or half full. That's the art.
Oh my God. That's awful.
Yeah. And there was a parody, a guy did a parody that was, he said...
I know the answer. The answer is, I know the answer to that question, if it's half empty or half full. It's sexist. That's what it is. It's not half empty or half full. It's... you ever seen that meme where it's a glass of water that's half empty? And then it's three parts. It says one over one picture. It says the optimist believes that this glass is half full. Then it says the pessimist believes that this glass is half empty. And then the feminist believes that this glass is sexist against women or something like that. So that's what it is. It's a sexist glass.
Who was the joke? How many feminists take to change a light bulb?
One to change the light bulb, one to hold the light bulb, and the rest for the wait and wait for the world to turn or something like that.
Yeah, the world turns around her or something like that.
Let's see what the chat is saying as I butchered that joke. Oi, degrees are meaningless. Holy shit. You guys ever work on a larger team project? No. Brian should make period blood paintings. Yes, as soon as I can make period blood. But unfortunately, there is a system that's keeping me from doing that, and I think it's sexist against men. Let me see. I'm trans misogynist, which means transition into being a misogynist. Check your privilege. I think whatever is considered good art for a given time period is whatever reflects the emotional state of the world at that time. Yeah, it makes sense. That's why I think we don't, like, I remember I was in one of my classes with my teacher, and we were talking about all the art movements and all of the different, like, cultural, you know, shifts that were going on. And I asked him, I said, so what is the art movement now? Like, what is the in thing? And he said, we don't know yet. We won't know until later. And that's how I knew that this whole thing is, like, kind of bullshit. Because what he's saying is that as far as people in the art world, which I think are part of the problem when it comes to art personally, because they really want to maintain its validity. And so what they do is they start essentially deciding what art should be, when I don't think that's the way it works. I think that things should just happen naturally. And, you know, somebody makes something, and if people like it and they go see it, then that pretty much says it. But the art world has always been something that artists had to rebel against to some degree. So I think that, that this is like a situation that isn't really much different from that.
And they now they want to. I see a lot of social justice warriors saying like, people who draw, we are not artists, we are artisans, and we don't do art because we just do drawings of things without political message and all that.
Exactly. That's exactly it. That they want, they think that something has to have a political message, otherwise it's not really art. And of course I disagree, you know. So I think that oops, I got too close. Zoom out.
Yeah, I mean, think if you ask me if I think that one of my drawings is better than a glass full or half full, yeah, it is.
If it's what?
It's if I think if you ask me if I think that one of my drawings is better than a glass half full, yeah, it is.
Oh yeah. But yeah, they think that it because they want, see, that's the thing though. If art has to be political, then doesn't that mean that art has to serve a purpose? It has to have a utilitary, you know, a utility function that in their case, it has to get people to think or to question or to act in a certain way in order to respond against something. The thing is that they say that art should be political, but I don't think that that's the whole answer. I think that they think it should be political in that it has to reflect their politics. Because
most of the art of the past don't have any political message or any message at all.
No, I mean, a lot of it was just for beauty purposes. Like when Van Gogh was making paintings, he wasn't trying to say anything. Although, to be fair, there was a lot of art that was made because of religion. And some could, you know, one could argue that that is a political, you know, or at least making a moral statement. But I don't think that, you know, again, if people think it's beautiful, I don't see a problem, you know, if they like it.
There was a lot in university, a lot of teachers and people trying to like explain a message for the art of the past, and many times it didn't have any sense. Like you have a drawing like a woman making potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
And they try to say, oh, this mean this and that, and he wanted to reflect the, I don't know, the meaning of life, and it's just a woman with a potato.
Yeah.
And the author probably was only thinking that he had to sell to eat.
See what the chat's saying.
Someone is discussing art in the chat.
Airflow, are you guys using a pad or a USB device? Yes. You didn't catch this from the beginning, but I have an Intuos, and Ku has a Cintiq. Okay. I don't think art needs to be anything except what the artist wants. Yes, absolutely. I agree. Make what you want. If people like it, that's great. If they don't, fuck them. It's basically my opinion. I mean, that's all it really should be. I think that some of the best things that have been made were probably because the artist really wanted to make them. Even if they were, you know, political or had some kind of message. Even if they were, if the artist really wanted to make them, then they will probably turn out, you know, better because the passion is there to do it. And
sometimes he don't even have to be trying to do art. Like the pictures of the prehistoric people are considered art, and they didn't do it for that intention.
Which ones?
The prehistoric art.
Oh, yeah, right.
They did it just because they thought that if they did it, they will hunt more creatures.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're talking about the prehistoric stuff. And that's absolutely right. It was done I think it was partly to show people how, maybe how to hunt, as well as, it was sort of like a primitive form of idol worship, essentially thanking, you know, the gods or whatever. I don't know. It could be for any number of reasons, but like no one knows for sure. But yes, I don't think it was intended to be art. It just so happened that we look at it now and we say, oh, these are very good depictions of animals, people would be hunting and stuff, and it was pretty cool. I'll be the roundabout.
Have you seen they have announced that Bayonetta is in Smash Bros?
Yes.
And the social justice warriors are trying to make Nintendo to not include her in the game. There is a petition.
Really?
Yeah.
So stupid, but not unpredictable. That's weird. I don't know. It's not that weird. Social justice warriors don't surprise me anymore. They just hate fun. They do. They're just anti-fun. They're just, I don't know. And I know it's like academia. I swear that's where they get it. It's school. It's these teachers that have like, useless degrees themselves that ended up becoming teachers because they wanted to fight the patriarchy from within the system, but without knowing that the system is full of people just like them. And they just want to like brainwash children. I don't know. Well, good luck with that. But do petitions ever work? I mean, like I hear like every time something happens that pisses people off, they start like they go to change.org and they try to start a petition. I feel like that stuff happens so much and nothing ever comes out of it. It just becomes a joke. I don't think petitions work, guys.
Yeah,
maybe I'm wrong. I have
ever seen one work.
Yeah, I'm serious.
I mean, they in a way they contribute to the fear. You know, like the reason why things like Dead or Alive don't come to Europe is it's like everything helps in that.
Uh huh.
Like the petition itself don't make the company to change their mind, but one petition and another and a lot of people in Twitter all combined.
Yeah, it's crazy. I think I don't know. Maybe it does. I don't want to underestimate them, but it can be really frustrating to see social justice warriors in a constant state of fucking trying to change everything.
I have to train in debating social justice warriors, because I will have there will be in Spain in March, there will be a public debate about Gamergate, and I am the main proponent.
Oh, really?
And we still don't have an anti. I mean, we are searching, because all the people in the organization of the convention are pro Gamergate, so we are lucky.
Right. Let's see what the chat is saying. Find your own background music. Enjoyment as art. Brian, he still has a lazy eye. I see that. I can move things around. It's whatever. They might have also done it for fun. I don't see why not. Is this over? Wasn't Bayonetta designed by a girl who wanted to make a strong, empowered female character? Yes. Yes, it was. And her outfits. I mean, you could actually, when I played the first Bayonetta, it was actually really obvious to me that there was a feminine, or not a feminine, but there was a woman that was probably behind the design of the game based on a lot of the aesthetic elements that it had. And not that a man couldn't do it, but I could tell, like, I was like, there must have been a woman involved, because the way that Bayonetta walks, the way that she carries herself, the clothes, the music, the, you know, just the aesthetic, the design.
The concept is different from people from Japan and here. So an empowered woman from Japan is a woman that uses her sexuality with no problems, and she beats people and gets beaten too. But in Occident, it's like she can't be beaten, she can't wear sexy clothes.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. And in America, it's just it's a different attitude.
I think it was the president from Sony that said that a few days ago, that the concept of the treatment of yeah, like I think it said the concept of woman empowerment was different in Japanese games. But there seem to be more and more companies from Japan that don't want to have problems with that and don't release their games here.
Yeah.
But they don't want to take our games away.
No, they don't want to take our games away. That's not their plan. When will there be another art stream? I don't know. I want to do them pretty regularly. We have on staff, we have a lot of artists, and most of them I think are digital. So, you know, it's hard to say. I want to do one pretty soon. I want to try something completely different from what I've been doing all this time. Hold on. All right, we're going to do another drawing here. Just a moment. But yes, I don't know, Ku, would you like to do these regularly on this channel?
Yeah, I don't see why not. If it's in a good time for me, because we have very different time zones.
Yeah, we're like 7 hours apart, guys, because he's in Spain and I'm in Chicago.
Yeah, but like, I think I'm gonna be called for dinner now, and you are probably in the middle of the day.
Yeah. Yeah, that's just it. Like, it's the time zone's a big deal. So, no, let's see what the chat has to say. But yeah, we'd I'd be certainly, you know, cool with trying.
Well, I have to go to dinner now.
Okay.
So I will have to stop.
All right, cool. We can stop. Let's see. So, oops. This is what I was working on. Let's see what you have. We'll go ahead and end it here. So, guys, if you you guys got to go to Cuckoo's website. I'll put it in the low bar, and I'll also direct you to mine, and we'll try to organize another one. Maybe put some word out in advance because we should go. Allison and Karen are going to set up the Rant Zerker, and I don't want to step on them. So. Thanks for coming on the stream. And yeah, we'll talk to you guys next time. Thank you, Ku, for joining me.
Goodbye.